question is the crisis creates an immediate product.
There are three main stages when it comes to production. These are pre-production, the planning, scripting, and storyboarding. Production, the actual shooting and recording. And post-production, everything between production and creating the final master copy. These production stages are what is required to complete a media product, such as a film. These stages start from an idea and fall into a final master copy.
Every script has to start with a good idea, a question you'd like to answer. When a script reaches post-production stages, we have gone through about 12 to 13 drafts. Every producer and director wants something to tantalise them and invite them in. They're looking for something that will not just inspire the audience, but the audience they're appealing to. And every script has to have a beginning, a middle, and an end. Without this, your script will have nowhere to go. How else can you tell you've been given a good script? This is a combination of instinct and knowledge of the market. Once you have finished your pre-production script, it is ready to move on to post-production.
Post-production scripts. Transcripts and post-production scripts are necessary part of the post-production process. These can either be done in-house from your own production team, or you can outsource them to a specialist service. A post-production script is your film or paper, shot by shot, word by word. Most film or TV makers want a post-production script. This is used for dubbing your film from its original language to a foreign one, to reverse a film, change major parts and subtitle it. Post-production scripts can vary in detail, but will have to include vision, audio, music and time code.
All post-production scripts are complicated and time-consuming, so booking a fast typist is not necessarily the best way forward. Whoever produces the PPS needs to know what they're doing, because they will have to go through the program a number of times to include all the required detail. For example, a 60-minute program will take approximately 10 hours. Here are a few ways to help speed up the process of producing post-production script. Use a specialist post-script service. Outsourcing your post-production script can save production time and money. Email your final as recorded commentary script to the transcription service. They can cut and paste this into their document rather than having to audio type from the finished product. But they will need to check it through to ensure you missed nothing. Email the producer's roughly transcribed sync script to the transcription service. It may not be perfect, but it will give them a head start. Nowadays, most producers have to submit a rough sync script with rough cuts and fine cuts as well as video lines to help basics find their way through program and viewing.
Even at very early stages of the development, the production investors are already thinking about what might happen when the film is at the cinema. It is critical when you're developing the film, you're specific of the audience type that you're aiming at. The most important thing is to connect the idea of the project to the audience. If you get this right, everything in between becomes a lot easier. However, if you get it wrong, it will never work. As a producer, you are the one person in the team who is prime consideration is who you are making. And are they going to spend their money on watching this? And if so, will they do this sufficient enough numbers to justify the cost of making the film? In addition to all of this, you will need to also make something that the audience will understand. Because if it is wacky and out there, people aren't going to get or understand the storyline. However, you need to be fresh without being completely weighed out. If no one is going to watch, read, play, buy the text, the producers aren't going to make any money or get their message across. Audience research is a major part of any media company's work. They use questionnaires, focus groups and comparisons to existing media texts and spend a great deal of time and money finding out if there is anyone out there who would be interested in an idea.
Role of the producer. The producer is the person that oversees the whole production of a film and plans and organises it all. They are either employed by a production company or independent. A and they help the creative people as well as accounting personnel. There is generally one main producer who can sometimes hire executive associate co-producers to do particular jobs. Some of the production roles include...
attractive investment. UK producers can go to television companies for funding like Channel 4 or BBC Film. If they are working in a particular region, they can go to the Regional Film Fund. It is more common to get a group of potential financiers, usually between 3 to 10. Particular financiers like particular subject matter slash directors, so producers go to them because they're more likely to invest. Foreign investment. Most producers look to America for co-production deals if they can't get enough funding in the UK, where an American producer can work together with a British one to find finance. It's easier to find one funder, but if they fund 100%, then they control the movie. But if it's multi-partner, where lots of people have funded, no one owns 100% of the movie, so the producer and director control it.
Marketing. Depending on what genre the film is, if there could be a certain time of year it should be released when it would make it more money, e.g. horror films to be released in Halloween. They must think about if they have a marketable star or director. The British film industry usually gets the finance and shoots the film, and then thinks about selling it later on. But Americans think about the release date and how they're going to sell it and market first, and then get on with the making of the movie, and this is why it's usually more successful.
Budget. This is how much the film will cost and how much it will be paid to finance the plan. Budget must include cost for the actors, cameras, film stock, editing, script and locations. The level of budget must be appropriate to how you think the film will make. Producer divides the cost into two parts and called above the line and called below the line costs.
Above the line costs is the creative side of making a film, so things like the scripts, paying for rights to the novel, the producer, the director, and their teams. Money is also paid for out of research as well. The above the line costs also pay for the principal cast, which is usually the two main characters in the film. However, it can be several more highly paid actors. Overall, the above the line films are the costs of creating the story. Below the line costs cover the people who are actually going to make the film and the film make the film, and not the people who are controlling the sales of the film. These people start at the beginning of pre-production and put together the shoot. They schedule things and set up each day. They do the designing and even the photography.
Okay.